So that's the pretty scary position for me, because every time I come through that elevator down here, I'm really afraid that something has happened to the stream. I've had friends who have been checking it out during the week, that during this week when I haven't been here myself. Now when I arrive here, well, it's apparent that it's still working. It's now, we still have, well, 2 days of streaming to go. Everything indicates that it's still working as it should. And there was also a small news article on a newspaper. It wasn't a critique as such, it was just a puff that there is this happening and you can come and visit it. That was quite as nice. I didn't expect anything more, really, in the time frame that we were building this system up. Just a brief reminder, up there we have a video cannon, which is comes from the Aalto University, and then we have a DVD player, which is hooked up into a time relay system, which kind of bluntly shuts the electricity down during the times. It shuts it down 8:02 in the evening, and then 8:08 in the morning it puts it on again. And I'm super pleased that that system really works, because making installations in public spaces using these kind of autonomous systems seems to be quite, it seems to be sustainable to some extent. Okay, it's gonna possibly continue this project in the future. We have plans now for autumn that we'll make something in the lines of consumerism in this screening. It will possibly be called Auto Art Screening at that time again, because it's kind of a nice name, and in that framework the auto would stand for autonomous and also automatic art screening. We still have a lot of flyers here, which indicates that people haven't really been using them. I think we have maybe half of them have gone, but that's not really a lot. I would have hoped that all of them would have been gone already, because it's been lasting for 2 weeks. So this is possibly the last update on the happening here. Again, thank you very much for everyone who has contributed their works and efforts to this project now. There's one more work there. Man, it has been fun. I mean, if we would have want to kind of develop it further, then the first thing to make the system even more better is to make a computer system up there, which would be automated as well. And then there would be some kind of web camera, which would be located over there, so that no one would have to come physically here to maintain the system. Nor would anyone have to like come in here and change the DVDs when the exhibition changes. Stuff could be just uploaded as it goes. That would be quite a revolution in itself as well. Kind of an automated video installation with user posted content, maybe something like this comes to mind. And also the video beamer that we have here is kind of an old cheesy one. If we were to go into kind of a more professional level, then we would really need a projector with more luminosity, because what I gather from peer reviews about this event is that people kind of just walk past it, and if the lights were kind of really brighter. I mean, like super brighter from this. The result would be that people would kind of have to stop just because of the flamboyance of the video work. I mean, I don't like flamboyant systems that much myself. I mean, generally speaking, but I think that in this offsite where we are now, such a system would be justified. Just to catch some eyes. The news show of the event was in Helsingin Sanomat, which is kind of the biggest newspaper in Finland. I haven't been able to find it. It was on a Friday edition. All right. I'll just leave you off with glimpses here. This is the route that people take when they come to their working places at Kamppi or just shopping or something like that. So you possibly have seen this from some of these videos already, but there's a lot of potential in these places. When we were talking with the executive director of the estate, she wanted us to develop some kind of systems here as well. Perhaps some light installations or photographs or something like this. Maybe a mural also. Why not? I can now see that there is a radio antenna for internet access here. So that would kind of suggest that there would be also possibilities to build internet connections to the computer if we put it up there. Oh man. So it's really working. I'm quite pleased. Quite a simple task, really, to get it working. Couldn't imagine that just putting a timer would make it so much less of a fuss. And here we see the parking garage area. Oh yeah, one thing that I kind of thought also, that what should be done for the development of it would be some kind of feedback channel. I'm not certain what it would be. Just maybe some kind of, not a book, because those get stolen and I would need to digitize it anyway in order to share it for the audiences that we're appealing, like people who kind of are just interested in it and want to know what kind of feedback there has been. It's probably online, we needed to put these feedbacks anyway, so there could be some kind of, I could imagine that Forum Pair, this BK Group, could possibly also have in their stock somewhere this like public access computers, which could be located there so that people could put some feedback to it, like a kiosk mode of a computer. I'm gonna ask them that. Now, I don't know if you can hear, but above you can hear bird sounds, and actually that's also a BK Group project that they're doing. They selected 23 different bird songs and they're playing these on a daily basis here. They attempted to play with radios, I mean come on, playing music here, but the result was that they had to pay money for the record companies, or Teosto, which collects those monies. And they wanted to go a little bit cheaper, so bird sounds it is. Okay, and that's Forum, and from there you can get up, and that's it. Come Sunday, I'm gonna come here and take the whole shit down, and that's it. Then be sure to expect some photographs of the event. I've documented it quite well. I mean, not well, but as well as you can do. And I'll leave you off with an image of an absolutely beautiful car. It's a moped car. That means that it's not a car, really. It's a motorcycle engine that it has, I think. Oh. 750 cc, that would mean that it's actually a car. Okay, but I know that there are mopeds like this as well. And too bad that they are museumized here. Okay, outdoor screening signing off. Thank you very much for attending.